indeed, his presence is heaven to us. Viewers at home, thank you for your time. I greet you, Emmanuel. If God be with you, your nature, thank you. You may be seated. Thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You have on the table our key responsibility as a Christian. So I'm to go straight to the emergency unit because I passed there the people that are not they are not happy to dance to join you. They are sick. I think that we should first attend to these people so that later they can come and while we are dancing, many of them are crying somewhere there. Hallelujah. Viewers at home. Let me share just 2 minutes words of wisdom. Words of wisdom. Hallelujah. So for the those who are waiting to receive healing and deliverance, words of wisdom. After that, we can now, after attend to the people at the emergency unit, we come back to the church once again. Let's quickly go to our friend. I think this message was given last Thursday. I think you still want to take it back again so that you have just 2 to 3 minutes of your time. Viewers, those who are sick around the world and those who are waiting for deliverance, hallelujah. Are you there? Let's look at our friend that have passed through this in the Bible, the biblical character. Let's go to the book of Job. Let's go to the book of Job. It's our friend. We are looking at his first step how to handle the situation. The book of Job, Job 1, chapter 22. Hallelujah. Okay, let's take chapter 21. I think that 21, I don't want to go to 22. That's 21 because of just the limited time we have now. Are you there? Job 1 verse 21. And he said, that is Job. Job said, naked I came from my mother's womb. Wow. Sometimes when you read that, it refers you to the first day when you were delivered. You say, nobody actually came with gold and silver. No matter what you are wearing now, no matter how beautiful or how you look, the first day, the very day you are delivered, your mommy is, if you are not crying, they will give you a beat. Bah, bah. They want to know whether you are still there. Whether you are still in the womb, they give you. Bah, bah, bah. So look at what Job is saying now. He's referring us to that. He said, naked I came from my mother's womb. And naked, oh my God, I want to cry. I want to cry. This really touched me, touched my soul, my spirit. Naked, shall I return there? Oh, no matter what they use on the last day to wrap you, to cover you, to do either gold, silver, coffee. By the time they just cover you with the dust and turn back, if care is not taken, some people are coming to dig your graves and carry your body. If I'm talking, let me see your hand. If care is not taken, and in the world we are today, if they realize that it is gold that they use for your casket, in this world, all over the world, if they realize that the casket is full of gold and silver and the gold, everything, immediately they dig the ground and cover you with the sand and everything. No matter the security, even the security people will be the one to dig the ground and carry the body. If I'm talking to you, let me see your hand. They will dig it and carry the gold. They will be looking for buyer. Gold care. Carry it. Or whatever you wear, whatever they want for you, then they will remove it from your body. And the casket to look for buyer. Huh? Oh. Look at what Job is saying now. This is what Job is telling you now, that look, I take it again, say, Naked I came from my mother's womb, and naked shall I return there. Oh, the Lord gave and the Lord has taken away. So that is when he was in a deep, in a serious, when I say serious, when friend and all other desert you, abandon you, to say, look at this one, they say, it's a devil, as a sort of his handwork, that's why he's suffering. They say, maybe it's occultic man. They say, no, it's occultic man. No, you better run, so that they will not turn this thing against. The Lord gave and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Wow, what could brought about that? He said, naked I came, and naked I will return. What does that mean to you today, presently? After reading it, I just come to my senses. I say, oh my God, give me the meaning for this. This means no one can be so poor as it was, as he was at birth. Tell your neighbor, no one can be so poor as he was at birth. I can hear you. Again. Can you turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, you cannot be so poor as you was at birth. No one can be so poor as he was at birth. You say, oh, I'm poor. I'm this. I'm that. I'm that. You say you are poor. You remember how you came. And also remember how you return. No one can be so poor as he was at birth. Yes. When you have this in your heart, with you, this wisdom, no matter the situation you are in, blessed be his holy name. The purpose of life is to glorify God in good times and hard times alike. The purpose of life is to glorify God in good times and hard times alike. You know, what my Bible made me to understand, those who blessed God in trouble prove their sonship. Yes, I'm a child of God. You must honor God before men. Situation today, look at what's happening around the world today. You must honor God. No matter situation, no matter what come, you must honor God before men. Prove your sonship that I'm a child of God. That you are saved does not make you an unbeliever. Tell your neighbor that you are sick does not make you an unbeliever. I can hear you. That you are poor does not make you an unbeliever. A man can be sick in body, yet be a friend of God. A man can be sick in body, yet be a friend of God. Don't let your situation mislead you. Tell your neighbor. I can hear you. I can hear you. I can hear you. I'm taking you back to the book of Job. That Job 1 verse 21. I call it words of wisdom. Before I move down there. Words of wisdom. That you are sick does not make you an unbeliever. Because when you see a man sick, they call him whatever name they call that sickness, cancer, on the seabed, you see him, oh. You know the problem we are facing now? Let me tell you, write this thing down as words of wisdom. It is never prosper to base faith on our improvement after prayer. It is never prosper to base faith on our improvement after prayer. In the name of Jesus, I'm sick. In Jesus' name, heal me. I need healing. Because that healing is not come. You say you are not a Christian. Satan is using that against us. That is what Satan is using now. Next time you cry, Jesus, and you are not receive answer to your prayer, you say, maybe because of my sin, or I'm not a believer. That Satan is using that key now to destroy people's faith. People's faith. It is never prosper to base faith on our improvement after prayer. That's what you say. People say, ah, look at it, he's going to church. Yet you are still poor. See you. You have not received healing. Go to which doctor now? Go and see this spiritually. Don't waste your time. Some of your friends say, you have not come, you have not been coming to church, yeah, because I'm not here. Because I'm not, I'm still having the pain. Because my debt keep increasing. The situation increasing, so I cannot continue coming to church. It is never prosper to base faith on our improvement after prayer. I call it words of wisdom. And I know, and like I used to say, people say my message look somehow. Because somehow my message will always be attack. Not me. That message will always be attacked. I know many of you have the belief that the teaching many have today is that once you are sick, you are not a believer. But a man may be sick in body, yet a friend, a candidate of heaven. If a man is lying down on the seabed, and later at the end of the day, the man died. It will be too soon for you to say he's going to hell. Because a man can be sick, yet a friend of God. But if you know this, Satan cannot come near you. And Satan is telling you that, look, see, your prayer is the answer. You keep shouting, your prayer is not answered. You say, please, shut up. It is never prosper to base faith on our improvement after prayer. You have been based your faith. On your improvement after what? That is why your faith is going down. Faith in Christ is what? Faith in Christ is what? This is how you base your faith. Result of your prayer. When your prayer answer, I'm close to God. When your prayer answer, I'm close to God. When my prayer answer, God loves me. When my prayer answer, I'm in the right, yeah, it's okay for me. No. Devil want to use, want you to curse God. Are you with me? Devil want you to curse God. Why under pain? Tell your neighbor, devil want me to curse God. Why under pain? I can't hear you. Look at me. Because what will be, what you be vomit or saying when you are under pain? I don't know what is wrong. I pay my tithe. I go to church regularly. This my friend is a smoker. I know him. He never sick one day. But I'm not a smoker. If I'm talking to you, let us say, hon, that it is time to compare yourself to others. This my friend sleep in the clubhouse. He has no wife. He sleep in the clubhouse. He never one day have contracted cancer or whatever. But me, I'm decent. I live right. I'm a Christian. I've been upright since I accept Jesus as my Lord and Savior. Why this cancer? Devil wants you to curse God. Why under pain? Why under trouble? That is why the devil makes delight in afflicting pain on people. That is why the devil, what? Make delight in inflicting, I call it inflicting pain. I'm not so afflicted. Inflicting pain on people. Take note of that. He's always happy. It's always happy. When, you know when you have pain. Yeah, yes, there's trouble between you and your creator. You know you vomit. You look at God in a bad light. You know, when there's blessing, everything is going well. Look at when he came to God. He said to God, "You said Job is upright, is honest man, is good. Tell me why Job will not be honest. Tell me why Job will not be a holy man." When you have blessed him with everything, he has this, he has children, he has money, he has car, he has good hair, and you are saying he's a holy, he's a honest, he's a good man. Tell me why you will not be good when he has everything. Allow me to touch him and see whether he will not change his confession. Tell your neighbor, devil wants you to curse God. Why under pain? I can't hear you. Listen, go and read that chapter. He came to God, Satan said, "Hey, you say Job is the most honorable person in the world. He's a holy man. He's a good man." Satan said, "Tell me why he will not go be good. He has everything. He lacks nothing. He has money, he has good head, he has the children are doing good. And you say he's good man. Why he will not good? Okay, if you say he's good, please leave me, just let me go and touch him. Touch those things and destroy them. And see whether he will not change his confession." And the Lord said, "Okay, go ahead, but I will not give you his word." No, don't go there. Everything you can touch, but that. You know, Christianity lies in the heart. Tell your neighbor. Not in the property. Not you have property, you have fame. That does not make you a Christian. But in heart. Christianity lies in the heart, because the Bible says faith is of man's heart. Is of man's heart, and only faith pleases God. Lead me, let him touch those things, let him destroy those things, let him touch those things, and see whether he will not come out to confess, nonsense. In the same way you are facing today, those who bless God in trouble prove their sonship. Tell your neighbor. I can't hear you. I can't hear you. I can't hear you. Those who bless God in trouble prove their sonship. That I'm a child of God. You're a child of God because he has car. He has house. He just newly bought a new Mercedes car. I'm a child of God. You see today in the whole world, when you see people say, yes, I'm a child of God. Go, just move close to him and say, so you're a child of God. Yes, I bought the building car. I have this. God bless me so much. That is why he's a child of God. Let that vehicle he used to carry family to the church. Let Satan touch the engine of the vehicle and meet him at home. Brother, you are not coming to church because my car is not good. Me, he could not bless God in his war. In his war. In his trouble. He could not prove his sonship in his war. I am a child of God because business is booming. There's money in the pocket. Today, this is how we know a child of God. If I'm talking to you, let us see your hand. We know child of God when money is in the pocket. Tell your neighbor. I can't hear you. We know children of God when there's food on the table. When the marriage is smooth, everything is fine, the children are doing well. Oh yes, I'm a child of God. That is how we assess, how we know true children of God today. In the war. The war turned upside down. Situation is now misleading people. People are being misled by war. Where's the teacher? Where's the teacher? Look at you here today. When the going are good, you wear beautiful dress to church. People can know when the going is at all. Go move around the church. You look at the faces. Some that used to rub makeup, they may not rub makeup today because the going are not good. Go to the car park. You see many cars at the car park there. When the goings are not good, you come with a public or this common vehicle. But when the goings are good, you come with a posh car with music. You can see the goings are good. Where are we going? The purpose of life is to glorify God in good times and hard times alike. Those who bless God in trouble, those who bless God in situation, those who bless God in temptation, prove their sonship. I want to leave you, but take this one once again. It is never prosper to base faith on our improvement after prayer. In the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ, I need bread. You fast, you pray, I need bread. And at the end of the day, the bread does not come, and you allow that to affect your faith in God, and you begin to look at God in a bad light, you see that you compare yourself. Look at this man, he's never even fast for 3 days, but he received bread. This man, he come to church regularly, occasionally, but the bread I'm asking for so long, for a long time, since long time now, he just received it, and it doesn't, it's not a regular church. See me. Tell your neighbor, it is never prosper to base faith on our improvement after prayer. May God bless his word. I want to attend to the people there. Take it once again. That you are sick does not make you an unbeliever. Because this is our impression today. The Job became an unbeliever? The Job became an unbeliever? What happened to Job worse than cancer? It was later God began to replace. The children died, they died. A lot of things happened. Look at what the wife said. For a wife to say, look, what are you waiting for? Curse God. Which God? Hey, if you say you are serving God, are you telling me all what is happening are the reward of righteousness? Righteousness is sought. Tell your neighbor, righteousness is sought. Sin bring reproach. But what is happening to you is reproach. That shows that you are a sinner. My God. If I'm talking to you, let me see your hand. He said, oh, righteousness, salt. And sin bring reproach. If righteousness is salt, and God say you're a righteous man, and this has happened to you, are you being assaulted? No. Sin bring reproach. You, this is reproach. You are a sinner, blood sinner. Job said, you say I'm a sinner? Job looked down and said, oh my God. Look at what is happening. The closest person to me is calling me a sinner. Oh, what will I do now? The word came to Job. Job said to the wife, the one who has been giving us salad every day for many years, now he's given up bitterly. Why are you complaining? You know salad. You know you like salad too much. But bitterly, Funko, unless you're sick. Even if you're sick, no matter the sickness, if they put bitterly, you wake up. You see, for a long time now, long, for many years now, we have been eating salad. And you enjoy it. The wife said, yes, I enjoy it. But now, it is time for bitter leaf. Tell your neighbor, the purpose of life is to glorify God. In salad time and bitter leaf time. Thank you. I'm going to meet the people there. So tell the sick one that are waiting for healing, the purpose of God is to glorify God in good health and in sickness, shall I? So take note, if your faith is lifted up, let me see your hand. So all those complaining, trouble you have, each time you pray and your prayer is, you say your prayer is no answer. I will not use my mouth to say your prayer is no answer. Because what we are asking for, who know if your prayer in the past had been answered, who know what will have happened to you? I want to be a millionaire. I want to be a senator. I want to be president. In the past, you have been fasting and praying. If that prayer had been answered, who know what will have happened to you today? Ask your neighbor. I want to be this. I want to build a new house. I want to buy a private jet. I want to buy that. I want to be that. I want to be a millionaire. I want my business to be boom. In the past, you have fasted, praying. If that prayer had answered, who knows what will have happened to you? Who knows whether you will live to enjoy those things? Who knows what will have happened to your children with those posh cars you are praying to buy? Who knows whether you will have been on the seabed for many years while those blessings of your enemy enjoying them around you? Who knows? I was given a good example of what happened in Sudan sometimes in the past. A Christian brother who was called from the bush, they call him rebel leader. They call him in Sudan, come out of the rebel. Come and be the white president. Assume the brother has got the position of being a white president, he will have decided to remain in the rebel as inside the bush forever. He came out from the rebel and the beer was so, I know many of you that are history, you know whom I'm talking about. The beer was so, he looked like an animal, looked like a bushman. He came out, he was a Christian, a general, a soldier. He came out and they welcomed him. Bye, 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 bye. The whole world welcomed him. The United Nations welcomed. They said, "Oh, the matter, the whole thing has been settled." The second day, the whole beer was shaved. My brother looked good. I was in a vision. The Lord said, "Oh, if you can talk to this man to go back to remain in the wolf, inside the bush." He was not in that vice president for 3 to 1 month when the plane crashed. What you are asking in prayer in the past, what you were asking in prayer in the past, I want to buy a new house, I want to be a senator, I want to be a house of rep, I want to be a millionaire, I want to have a breakthrough in my business, I want to have more children, I want to have this, I want to have this, I want to have that, I want to have that. I want to have a good health in the past. Who knows what will have happened if your prayer in the past had answered? It is never prosper to base faith on our what? Improvement after prayer. Tell your neighbor once again. Again? It is never prosper to base faith on our improvement after prayer. That is, when my prayer answer, I have faith. My prayer answer, I have faith in God. That is why my prayer answer. I have faith in God. That's why my prayer answer. The one that the prayer is not answered, he keep looking at you, say, my prayer answer, I have faith in God. I'm close to God. I have faith. No. Sometimes when the Lord know what you are asking for, could be very dangerous for your future. The Lord will hold it. And you keep shouting. He will hold that thing. He will not. He will stop you a while in order to save your life. You want to buy a car and you have been praying to buy that car. Faster. And the Lord know if you have this car, it may be your son that will have accident and die inside it. He will refuse to give you such a car. Is that not blessing? I want to be this, I want to be that, and you are a Christian now. You are living, you have the fear of God, but suddenly you want to buy a sheep. And the Lord knows if you have this sheep, you will not have time for him. And you keep fasting and praying, fasting and praying, fasting and praying. Hey! Lord, no. Salvation of your soul is greater than anything. You are too dear for him. He may stop you a while. That thing you are asking for, he will still give you, not now, but until you are very, very strong. He wants to strengthen your desire first before giving you what you are asking for. To strengthen your desire is a crime. You know, when you have this sheep, you may not have time for him. You will not have time for him. So you will want to strengthen your desire for him. After strengthening your desire for him, you want this thing for 1 month, 2 months, 3 months. It may take his time to strengthen your desire for 1 year. After 1 year, he strengthens your desire. He can give you, know, when you have this thing, you will still remain your faith. Tell your neighbor, it is never prosper to base faith on our improvement after prayer. Thank you. I'm going to imagine you. Thank you. You may be seated. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, the little break we have has taken us back, and we are running out of time. We are asking for grace because we have many people that are still trying to check their flight back to their country. So we ask for the grace, the word of his grace. Hallelujah. The Bible says it is the word of his grace that builds faith into the believer. Not just word. Take note, there is word. There is word of his grace. There is word. That's what we call word. You can say in the name of Jesus, okay? There is word of his grace. And the word of his grace act on our spirits. That is, we say the spirit act upon the word. So it is the word of his grace that builds faith into the believer heart. It is the word that establishes, that word of his grace that establishes. It is the word that builds. So it's not everywhere that in Jesus' name be blessed and the person will be blessed. Unless you speak the word of his grace, it is the word that establishes, it is the word that builds. Hallelujah. Amen. That is what we are here for today. Hallelujah. Amen. Like I have said, there is the word of the Bible and the word of today. So the word of the Bible, that is the word the Lord used to create, to heal and to bless and to rule over us. So let's see what God has for us. If you don't mind, I mean, we have many of you that actually came from other country. If you only just one, we can listen to before we move.